What we do here is go
Right, where do I start? Hello everyone and welcome to a new series I like to call Content Catcher, which is a blatant ripoff and low-budgeted version of Content Cop. But even though this is a knockoff series, I like to believe that this will achieve the same thing as Content Cop, in which we expose scum on the internet, mainly on YouTube. Now, I wasn't actually planning to upload this week at all. Like, I even said in the description of the last video that I was going to take a week break and then come back to YouTube as soon as that was done. But as soon as I release this video, by the way, if you haven't seen this video, please go watch it. It is great for you and not for me because, you'll see. Some toxic boy on YouTube decided, you know what, I'm going to release an expose video on Zac just because I've got nothing else to do and, you know what, let's just do it for the hell of it. The scumbag that I'm referring to is, in fact, this person here, known as LuckIsImpossible on YouTube, but I'm going to refer to him as Luck.
But like COVID-19, Zac himself has risen up like a plague to destroy us all.
Now in Luck's video, he refers to me as this COVID-19 virus that's going to rise up to destroy everyone, which I find kind of funny, to be honest. It's such a poor way to describe me, because it actually benefits me more than it does him. And yes, COVID-19 has killed a lot of people, no one's denying that. But COVID-19 has also done a great deal for humanity in which it has cleared the skies of pollution in certain countries and has also made people self-aware that life is more precious than we deemed it to be. And that is what I am, a cure for pollution on this platform, especially for scumbags known as LuckIsImpossible. But you know, I'm going to give myself a bit more of an accurate name, which is better suited for the situation that we're in, and also structures the video just how I want it. I want to be known as the Big Bad Wolf, because in Luck's situation, he's making me seem like I'm this terrible, lying, hypocritical racist, which actually those three points match up exactly how I want this video to be structured. Straw is going to be represented by lying, Sticks is going to be represented by hypocrisy, and Bricks is going to be represented by racism. All three sections in Luck's video that make me seem like the bad person he describes me to be. But what Luck doesn't realise is that I am more than capable at debunking all his points and using them all against him, just to prove what a lying, hypocritical, racist he actually is. I'm going to huff and puff and blow all his points to smithereen until there is nothing left. So buckle up, because we've got one hell of a hypocrite to prove wrong. So my first part of the video, the straw house, the liar. Now to prove that Luck is actually the true liar in this situation, let's have a look at this I caught last night. As you can see, I'm talking to Luck in the DMs, and little does he know, I'm trying to bait him out to be the liar that he actually is. I placed my trap, and he took the bait. Look at that. He says he wasn't typing, but I caught him in the act. Luck is a liar.
That's not the reason I've made this video. The reason I made it is because he's finally pushed his harassment too far.
No, the reason why you made this video is because you've got nothing better to do. And yeah, with COVID-19 coming up, of course, sir, you can have a lot of free time to criticize people that clearly are just having fun on YouTube and doing what they love.
Not only has this man been harassing me for the better part of 3 months now.
I've been harassing you for 3 months? Where's the proof? You didn't show any proof. Where did it go? No one knows.
And he's gay for a lion.
Gay for a lion, is he? Again, Where's the proof? You've got nothing on me.
I wasn't gonna say anything about how bad he's been lately and how he's been a terrible person, but then he sent me this screenshot right here.
And yes, I did send this message to him, but I only sent it because he provoked me first. Yep, that's right. Luck swang first and I hit harder. So you're the piece of shit.
He acts like he hasn't played Minecraft for years.
Minecraft? I got rid of that years ago.
Now, not only was this a sketch to refer to the days when I used to play Minecraft in my squeaker voice, but there are two key little details that you missed out on. One being that I missaid years and should have said days instead, because that was my intent.
And to prove that this wasn't just a one-off slip-up, listen to what I say in my most recent video.
2014, a bit like the one we played 2 years ago, the 420 Blazing Game of the Year. Because accidents happen all the time, and you would know best of all. I mean, take a look at your own video, for example.
Send me this screenshot right here. And a lot of these pictures feature...
You see, no one's perfect, but I'm better than you. And the second thing I want to mention about this point is the fact that he missed out on one crucial little detail that you could have easily seen throughout this video. Let's skip a little bit further into the video. Did you see it? Here, I'll play it again. And right there. There it is. As you can clearly see from my video, Minecraft was deleted on exactly the 4th of May 2020 at 2 o'clock. Exactly 4 days before this video was released. What does this mean? Obviously, it was a sketch, and your point is now invalid.
He used to be a really nice guy. He made some genuinely amazing videos.
Now, when he refers to generally amazing videos, you know he's only talking about I'm fat, right? Like, this is the only video he ever talks about whenever my videos come up. And he's always asking for the second one. When's the second one coming out? And because of this, he's gone in this angry strop because he's butthurt that there'll never be an I'm fat 2. So my second part of the video, the stick house. The hypocrite.
With all the drama going on recently.
With all the drama that's going on. Did Luck copy content? The same thing he criticized me for? Oh no! You know, I'm gonna refer to you as Little Luck. Do you like that, Little Luck? Do you like the fact that I'm proving you wrong? Now, Little Luck is trying to make me seem like a bad person for taking someone else's content. Which, in the same video, I do reference where the original video came from. And if that is the case, then doesn't that mean that you copied this video from H3H3's video? You know, the exposed video? The same video you used to expose me on? Hypocrite!
When in reality, on our shared channel that we're all a part of a group in, we literally have a series that I think we've recently filmed 4 episodes for, of which he is in 3, actually. By the way, he has a guy in there named MT.
Now, what I like about what he says here is he's not only being hypocritical, but he's also being a bad friend to MT. I mean, MT is in that very same series that you're exposing me for not mentioning. Why are you dissing him too? Don't you steal content for personal gain? I mean, just look at MT's series, for example, Mexican Border Roleplay, which you deliberately stole from him for your personal gain. But you still refer to MT as some guy?
The hypocrisy!
Oi, Little Luck, stay up there. We belong.
When you look at his new videos, which I like to call the shit series.
The shit series, huh? Well, let's look at your quality content, because obviously you make better videos than me.
Oh yes.
Farmer in the Dell.
Wow, quality content.
He does literally all of those things, you know, the happy persona, the clickbait, the consistent uploads. What a fucking guy.
A happy persona, eh? Now, where have I seen this before?
He's dead! I got him! I'm a hero! Come on, Mark! Come on, Mark!
Is that Luck's happy persona? Oh no! Little Luck's being a hypocrite! Catchy thumbnails, huh? Let's look at your thumbnails! Look at those clickbait thumbnails! Hypocrisy!
Thank you.
So my third and final part of the video, the brick house. The racist. Now, I know what you're going to say, the Big Bad Wolf never blew down the brick house. And you are totally right, but what Luck forgot to do was cement his house with concrete facts, making his house vulnerable for criticism.
Several people of color and various other minority groups that I know that are mutual friends with me and Zac have come to me and said that Zac has been harassing them and bullying them about their skin color.
Now, this part of the video, he makes me seem like I'm this big old racist Zac, which he claims to have solid evidence on, with it being that he has testimonies from different minority groups which can vouch for his case. Which, in my opinion, is one of his weakest points in this video. Why? Because all those supposed minority people in his video, they're all white! I can't be racist against someone who's white! Who do you think you are? False racism claims! Oh no, little Luck messed up again!
I called Zac on the phone, and I asked him, do you want to kill puffins together? And he told me no. And then he said, Tun rasa ir vaikari o min the epic in mine.
But what Dell doesn't tell you is I did say yes to puffin hunting, but with one condition. Can Gordon Ramsay come? Have you not seen the video of him puffin hunting? My god, my man is a natural. And he's British too, why not? And when he talks Faroese to everyone assuming that I know Faroese, I mean I can barely speak my own language. That is when I am actually talking about Gordon Ramsay, but in his head, he's blocking everything out because he doesn't want to hear it. He's making up lies. Now, out of the four victims in this video, only two of them are mentioned in the description. How weird. It's almost like Luck doesn't actually care about these people and he's only using them for self-gain. Little Luck, how could you? Also, if you want to talk about being a racist, let's look at one of your videos.
Slave, I have a task for you.
Luck supports slavery. Oh my god, Little Luck, no! Now this next part of the video is very sad and tragic all by itself. Luck, this innocent man he portrays himself to be, is a racist. In one of his latest videos, The Hunt for Tobuscus, you can clearly see that he is stalking an innocent Mexican man who at some point did sound a little bit British, but that was just probably him just being funny. But it also could support the fact that he's racist against British people. Another reason why he made this video. He's biased. So in this video, he proceeds to go after this man, Tobuscus, even though all he's doing in this video is he's just living out his life, living his day normally as you would. What does Luck do? Stalks him down and kills him. Truly a tragic moment. If that ain't a racist, then I don't know what is. And in this same video, you can clearly see what him and his group support under. Truly disgusting. These brave victims of Luck is Impossible are here today to tell their stories, and here are their testimonies.
Oh man, so Luck, he's a completely different person off camera. I mean, he's kind of an asshole even on camera, but he's like 14,000 times worse off camera. He abuses almost all the We Cult members every day for no reason. He all the time that is spent off camera, all he does is just call us horrible names and horrible, horrible racist slurs. And I mean, that was a frustrating, but I can deal with it, you know. But that video it's too far. Like, and in the video, he says, like, he calls out Zac for pretending he doesn't know our series, when he acts like he doesn't know who I am. He says, this MT guy, and I was in that series that he brings up. He doesn't even know who I am. Oh my god. He also stole my Mexican Border Roleplay series. I was the first person to do a Mexican Border Roleplay series, if you didn't know. No one else did. I started it back in, the 1980s, but, he stole the concept. He's really jealous of me and Zac's success. He made that video, it has a whole 40 views. That's like one of the most viewed videos on YouTube or something. It's ridiculous. I cannot believe He's getting away with this. Stop watching that video. Stop it. That's all I gotta say. Also, he kills children.
Where do I begin with that cuck? Ooh. You know, I'm Vietnamese myself, and seeing as he is a racist, he did try to murder my family. He didn't murder my family, he failed on that part, but he did murder all Vietnamese kind. You see, he took me to a nice Vietnamese convention one day, and he said it was for to get ice cream. He wanted to give me ice cream after being such a good friend. And he took me to the convention. I didn't know it was a convention. And there's millions of Vietnamese people, and they were all closed in a singular room. And then he just pulled a lever and he gassed them all, and he said he loves Vietnamese people, and he told me to look away. I couldn't help but just watch as my kind died right in front of my very eyes. Oh my god. I can't go on talking about it anymore. This is my testimony.
So, Luck, you know, gives me a DM one day saying, hey, I'll give you 3 cents if you say a bunch of racist shit about Zach, and, well, I took the 3 cents. He also gave me the sandwich. This sandwich is really fucking good. Boom.
Yeah, I remember when it all happened. It was just awful, man. Luck came up to me one day, and I was just like, oh, hey, Luck, how's it going, man? What you doing? And then he said, hey, say something shitty about Zach. And then I said, no, why would I say something shitty about my friend? And then he threw me in a basement with, like just dead rats everywhere, and there was just some creepy guy in the corner, and then he tied me to a pole, and then he said, you better fucking say something shitty about Zach, and he pulled out a fucking rocket launcher and held it to my face, and I said, oh, okay, just give me audacity and a fucking microphone. And then so he forced me to say those things. I didn't believe a single word of it. None of that happened. So Zach, you didn't punch me in the dick, you didn't throw hot tea in my face, but Luck definitely held a rocket launcher to my face, and said you better fucking say something or I'm gonna drink all the coke and eat all the nuggets. And I was like, oh dude, don't eat my nuggets. And then he proceeded to eat all my nuggets anyway, so I'm still pretty pissed at him, but I don't believe a single word of it. You never punched me in the dick, Zach. You're a really cool guy. Yeah. Alright, so when the fuck do I get paid?
Alright, so the thing is, with this motherfucker, is that I catch him slipping every single time, but he just goes away. He's just a ghost. He's literally a ghost, right? But the thing is, right, he's actually black. He is black. See, in his video, right, he put Envy there, and Envy is his brother. And you see, his thing, his race or whatever, it's African American. That don't make sense. So Luck is actually an albino black man. All right, that's not all. This man is gay as well. Look at this picture, right here. He is gay. He is so gay. Just look at how gay this is. Look how gay he is. Yeah, gay. This man must be stopped. I swear, he just spouts this mindless drivel on this internet place. Yeah, and he's gay, did you know? He's fucking gay.
Truly brave souls. And you can guarantee that their links will be in the description of this video, as they rightfully should be. Something that LuckIsImpossible doesn't seem to care about. Thank you guys very much for watching this video. I know it's very different from what you're used to, but all of this needed to be said. And Luck, if you are watching this video, which I guarantee you are, I just want to let you know that your choice in username couldn't be more accurate. Luck is impossible. For you. Your reign of supreme is over. And your luck has just
ran out.